Hi, I'm Paulus, and today I'm going to show you an easy way to scrape reviews from Trustpilot. Whether you want to keep track of what your customers are saying about your brand, or gain insights from the reviews of your competitors, this is a great way to do it. So let's start. So we'll start by going to our GitHub Smartproxy page, where you will find all sorts of different repositories that can help you to set up our proxies or scrapers. And for this particular video, we have prepared a library called Trustpilot Python Scraper, which you will be able to clone and try yourself. As you can see, here we have 3-day trial, which will allow you to test our service using 3,000 free requests. And we will do that by clicking on the banner and registering on our dashboard. And once you have registered, you will see different kind of products that we have here. So in this particular case, we will be using the web scraper, so the web under scraping APIs. And to show you how this works, I will be using API Playground. So we will be scraping our own reviews page in Trustpilot, which is smartproxy.com. And once I enter this URL here, we will send a request. We can also choose different kind of parameters that we need for this page. So with web scraper, you can scrape any page, and this is why you may need different kind of parameters for your use case. So you can select the location, the language if you need the results in a specific language, if that website returns it in that language. And you can select device type, which can be desktop or mobile, and you can even specify which exact browser do you need. So in this particular case, I don't need any of these extra parameters, and I will be just sending my request. And once I do that, we have a task created, which now is running in the backend. So what happens in the backend? In the backend, we are now matching the best possible proxy to open this page, which in our case is Trustpilot. And additionally, we are looking at the best fingerprint possible for this request. So we are just looking at different kind of properties that will help us to unlock this website, and if it has any captchas, bypass those. So now we have our response, which contains information about our request, and the part that is most important for us is the content, which we will be using to get the full HTML of the website. So I will be copying this HTML code, and I will be placing it in my code editor, and then I will open the HTML in my browser. So now let's do this. I have the full HTML selected, and what I will do is I will import it to a text editor. In this case, I will be using Sublime. And once you do that, you can save this file as HTML and simply run it in your browser. However, you will notice that there are parts of the file that are not fully correct. So what you see here is a lot of backslashes, which you use to protect the content that we are scraping. So to remove the backslashes, what you can do is you can go to one of the pages that strips them, simply copy the HTML code, put it here, strip the slashes, and then copy it to your clipboard and save it as the file you will be running in your browser. So in my case, I saved it as index.html. Now I open this file, and we can see that it is exactly the same as the page we have started with. So what we are going to do is we're going to take one of these reviews and inspect it. Here now on the right side, we have the web developer tools, which will help us to select the elements that we want to extract. So see, they have a class, they also have a type, and inside there is text. What you can also find is that there is an element in the HTML that is a script that loads all the JSON. And what you'll notice is that this file contains way more information about the reviews that we are seeing here. And with some websites, you will find out that part of the data is available in JavaScript. And here we can see a lot of different data points that we can use. So what I'm going to do is I will show both examples. If your page has all the data you need in the HTML itself, then you will just go through the elements and extract it one by one. However, if the data is stored in the JSON, which is loaded using JavaScript, we will do the same process as with HTML. However, we will need to extract these data points a little bit differently. So let's go to the code editor and let me show you both methods and how we will do it. So now we are in our code editor, and here I have the Trustpilot parser example, which we will use to scrape the data out of HTML. And as a reminder, you will be able to find the links to our GitHub page where you can clone this parser down in the description below. So we will be using JSON library to save the data that we get as a JSON format. Then I will be using the requests library to send a request to our scraping API. And finally, we will be using Beautiful Soup, which will help us with the parsing part. So the URL will be the web scraper that we are using for this video. So we will be specifying all the necessary data in the payload. So the target is universal, which refers to our web scraping API. For the URL, we will be using Trustpilot. However, you can use any URL you want. We will tell it to scrape the page using JavaScript as well. And then we'll move to headers. So for headers part, the most important thing for us is the basic authentication. So we need to identify ourselves so that the web scraping API would know that request is coming from my account. And I can do that simply by, again, opening our dashboard and going to the API playground, then clicking copy here and inserting my username and password. Now down below here, we have a line that is a base64 encoded credentials that I just typed here above. And we will be using those to authenticate with our service. So let's just copy it over to my code editor. And now let's move to the main part of the code. So what happens here is we are calling the requests library to post the information that we just specified. Then we're using JSON data and saying that it is the response, the text of the response that we get. Then we load that data in JSON format. We then go over and go to the object that contains the content from the parsed data. So in the API playground, we saw that we have our object as a JSON and it has a content part. So this is what happens here. We're extracting information from that content part. So we're extracting the HTML file itself. Then if you remember, we were removing the backslashes from the code previously, and we also have to do that in code. So we're just going to replace all the backslashes in the response that we get. So once we remove the backslashes, we will now move over to Beautiful Soup and load that stripped content using HTML parser. Then we will go over and find each element that we want to extract data from. So if you remember me opening DevTools, this is exactly what we're doing. We're just looking at HTML code and finding items that we want to extract and then specifying them in the code by using their class name and specifying their type. So we go through each element that we want to be parsed. So in this case, we're parsing review text element, review date element, and review score element, which is the basic that we need to get this going. So next we will run a for loop that will go through all of the elements available, and then we have to store them in the JSON. So what we need to do is we need to create dictionary for each of these fields that we are extracting. Once that is done, we can then dump the output to the JSON file. So this is what we're doing. We are saying it to save all the data that we're extracting to the reviews.json file. And basically that is all we need for this code to become functional. So let's see how does the extracted data look like. Here we have everything that we specified. So the text, the date, and the rating. And it's all available in the JSON formatted file. So if that's all you need, then this code will be sufficient enough for you. However, as I mentioned, there are two ways to extract the data. One is from the HTML elements, and the other is from JavaScript loaded JSON file, which I am going to show you now. So in this example, the imports don't really change. What changes is we add glom, which will help us to export the data from the nested JSON file. We will be using the same URL, we will be passing the same payload and headers. However, we will be specifying our authentication again, so we can just copy it from our previous example or from the playground that I have shown before. And this will make sure that we are authenticated properly. The main code doesn't change a lot as well. We are still requesting the same web script page. We are getting the same data back. However, instead of loading or selecting the HTML elements, we just load the next data script. So we first find it by searching for its ID, which is next data, and then we extract the contents of the script tag and we load it in the JSON. So now we can access all the object data, and glom will help us to do that in an effective manner. So we can see that we are accessing all the information that was previously stored in JSON and save it to a variable. Then what we need to do is, once we have all the fields that we want to extract, we need again to create a dictionary for our JSON that we will use to export the data so we can use it later on. And once we have described all of the dictionary for the JSON file, we're doing the exact same thing. We're just dumping all information to a newly created JSON file, which in this case is named pageinfo.json. So let's open that file and see what we have. And this looks way more extensive than the code we had been using before. We have the email of the page that we are scraping reviews from. We have category, we have the overall score, and we also have individual scores that we were extracting from HTML one by one. So this is way more effective to do and allows us to extract more data. However, not all pages have this sort of JavaScript loaded object, so you should keep in mind that there are two different methods on how will you do it. So the HTML extraction that it showed first, and then the extraction from the JSON object that is stored in the loaded JavaScript. Easy, wasn't it? You'll find the link to our web scraping API down below. And don't forget that you can try all of this out completely for free using our free day trial. Until the next time.